Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org. JPA 2.2 was just a small maintenance release, but it nevertheless brought some interesting changes. You probably already know about some of the new features, like the retrieval of a query result as a stream, or the support for classes of the date and time API. These are the most popular changes, but not the only ones. JPA 2.2 also introduced a few smaller features that make it easier to use. One of them is that some of JPA's annotations are now repeatable. Up to Java 8, annotations had a major usability flaw. You were not allowed to annotate a class, method, or attribute with multiple instances of the same annotation. That's why JPA 2.1 used annotations like named queries that act as a container for an array of annotations. In this case, the named query annotation. A container annotation doesn't provide any value on its own. It just wraps an array of other annotations. And since Java 8 and the introduction of repeatable annotations, you often don't need to use container annotations anymore. Before we dive into the details of repeatable JPA annotations, let's quickly talk about the general concept of repeatable annotations. The implementation of a repeatable annotation is pretty simple, as you can see in the code snippet. It shows JPA's named query annotation, which became repeatable in version 2.2. The only change compared to JPA 2.1 is the additional repeatable annotation. It declares the container annotation, which the JPA compiler will use to generate the code that stores the repeating annotations. In this case, it's the well-known named queries annotation. I'm sure that you are already using it in your projects to store an array of named query annotations. As you can see, your JPA implementation still needs to provide the container annotations. But you no longer need to use them in your code. You can annotate your entity class with multiple, repeatable annotations, and the Java compiler will generate the code that stores them in a container annotation. JPA 2.2 introduced two new container annotations, and 16 annotations became repeatable. The new container annotations are table generators and sequence generators, which store multiple table generator and sequence generator annotations. And you can see the repeatable annotations here on the slide. That are basically all annotations for which you can find a container annotation in JPA 2.1. And don't worry, I will not read all of them. If you want to take a closer look at the list, you should pause the video now. Okay, before we end this video, let's take a quick look at the effect that repeatable annotations have on your code. You no longer need to wrap any of the repeatable annotations in a container annotation. As you can see in the code snippet, that makes the code easier to write and read. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video and an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate 5. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you like today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!